Hello friends, myself Amar. Now in this video I will discuss about multi-select list box in prime faces. Now multi-select list box is used to select an item from a collection of list boxes that are in parent-child relationship. Now what is the meaning of this statement? To understand this, let me show you the output first. Here as you can see, this is a multi-select list box. Now if I click on mobile, then you can see another list is generated. Now for this list, this one is the parent. For this mobile, this categories is the parent. Now if I click on Samsung, then again you can see some options are generating. Now for this Samsung, this mobile is the parent. That's why I told you here that this multi-select list box is used to select an item from a collection of list boxes that are in parent-child relationship. Okay, this means from this parent we are getting this child. Again for this child, this is the parent, right? Now if I select an item from here, suppose I am selecting M30. Now if I click on save, then the item which we are selecting from here, that will be displayed in this particular output text. Now how to use this multi-select list box, that portion I will discuss. Okay, for that what I have done, I have created a project. Okay, the name of the project is multi-select list box. Here I have a index.xhtml page, and inside the ripples code package, here what I have done, here I have created a package, a Java class actually named as multi-select bin. Okay, now if I go to index.xhtml, then here I have used the required prime faces and JSF tags. Then in the head section I have given a title multi-select list box. Then in the body section I have taken a form. Now to use the multi-select list box, here I have used multi-select list box component. In the value I have written msb.selection. This means whatever item I will select from the multi-selection box, that will be stored inside the selection property of the msb managed bin. Now if I go to bin, that is multi-select bin, here as you can see, here I have created the class multi-select bin and the name I have given as msb. Here I have created the property selection, okay. And this selection property has its corresponding getter and setter. As you can see, it has its corresponding getter and setter here. Now, whatever items we will select from the multi-select list box, that will be stored inside the variable or the property selection. Okay. Here I have given the effect bounce. Now, if you can see here, once we select the item, then it has an animation. Okay. It has an effect. Now, there are different kinds of effect. Here I have used bounce. Here you can use different kinds of effect. Okay, now here as you can see, here I have written header equals to categories, and that's why this categories header is reflected here. And there is a show headers property, I have made it as true. If you make it as false, then this header will not be displayed here, right? Now inside this multi-select list box, we need to display the items. This means these items, mobile TV, Samsung, Oppo, these items we need to display. And for that, here I have used select items, and in the value I have written msb.items. Now items is again is the property which has been defined in the multi-select bin managed bin. Here as you can see, here what I have done, here I have created a list of select items. The name I have given as items. Now in the init method I have created the object of the array list having the type as select item. Then here I have used the class select item group, and I have given the caption as mobile. Here I have created another select item group, given the caption as TV. Then again I have created the select item group, the name as Samsung mobile, and the caption I have given as Samsung. And for this select item group, the caption I have given as Oppo. Okay, now here just relate it with the output. Here as you can see, mobile and TV, this mobile and TV here I have created. Then we are getting Samsung and Oppo, means if you select mobile, then this Samsung and Oppo we are getting. For that I have created this. Okay, now similarly, if I select on TV, for TV we are getting LG, and to create this LG, here I have created another select item group. I have given the caption as LG. Okay, then once you select mobile, Samsung, then we are getting M30 and A50. For that, here I have created select item object. The caption is given as M30 A50. And after that, what I am doing, all these items which we have created here, that should be added with the Samsung. And to do that, here I have used the select items method and I am adding it with Samsung mobile. This means with this one. Okay. So I have written Samsung mobile dot set select item, new select item, after that the items, that is Samsung mobile 1 and Samsung mobile 2. Similarly, for Oppo mobile also, as you can see, if I select Oppo, we are getting 3 items. This means we need to create these 3 items, and these 3 items has been created here, right? Once we have created these items must be added with the Oppo mobile, and for that here I have written the code, right? Now, after that here I have written mobile. Mobile is the object of what? Mobile is the object of this select item group. Now this Samsung mobile and the Oppo mobile must be added under this mobile group, okay? And to do that, here I have written mobile dot set select items, Samsung mobile and Oppo mobile. Similarly, the LG TV which we have created here, this LG TV should be added with the TV mobile group. And to do that, here I have written TV dot set select item, new select item, here I have added LG TV, okay? After that, the items, that is mobile and TV, which we have created, should be added with the items, and to do that I have written items dot add mobile and TV, okay? And after that, this item property has the corresponding getter and setter. As you can see, it has its corresponding getter and setter, right? This means this F select item will fetch all the items and it will be displayed in this multi-select box, right? After that, I have created a command button having the value as save. In the update, I have written out. Now this out is nothing but the ID of this output text which I have created. Okay, here as you can see, in the output text the ID I have given as out, and in the value what I am displaying, I am displaying the value of the selection. As you remember, the items which we select from this multi-select box, that is stored inside the selection property. And the value which has been stored inside the selection property is displayed here. And to do that, here I have written value equals to msb.selection. Okay. And that's why once we select the item, once I click here, then the items which I have selected, that is displayed here. Okay. As you can see, this is working fine. Okay. And this is the entire code. As you can see here, this is the code for the index.xhtml. Just have a look. Here you can use different kinds of effect. Here I have used the bounce effect, okay? This is the code for index.xhtml. And the effect which we can use here, you can use different kinds of effect, as you can see, blind, bounce, clip, drop, explode. These are the different kinds of effect which we can use, right? And this is the code for multi-select bin. Just have a look. These are the corresponding packages. This is the class. This MSD is nothing but the name of the managed bin. After that, I have created select item property, as you can see. Now there is an init method. In the init method, I have written the code to create the select item group and the select items. Okay. This is the entire code for multi-select bin, right? I hope you have liked my video. If you have liked my video, please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for more Prime Faces video. Thank you so much.